It's St. Patrick's Day weekend, everybody! It's time to celebrate the work of St. Patrick, who converted the Irish from paganism to Catholicism. In America, this means getting medievally blackout wasted, I think. Howdy, Irish and non-Irish and Irish wannabes and everybody else. Trace here for DNews with some drunk science. Now there's drunk and then there's blackout drunk. Those are the times when you're so bombed that you literally have no memory of anything that you did or said. A whole chunk of time is just lost. Count yourself lucky if this has never happened to you, but why does this even happen? First, let's talk about how memories are made. Scientists aren't exactly sure, but they think it has to do with the hippocampus. On a normal day, the synapses of your brain communicate with each other to build your experiences. It's a chemical process pulling in information from your senses, your experiences, and your feelings at the time, all folded into the cells of your gray matter. Your cells communicate with each other using a neurotransmitter chemical called glutamate. Glutamate helps bridge the synaptic gap between brain cells so memories can be stored and accessed. But alcohol is a toxin that affects that glutamate. See where I'm going here? According to a study in the journal Alcoholism, Clinical and Experimental Research, functional MRI scans of drunk students found our brains, once intoxicated, increase blood flow to the parts that control attention and cognitive functioning, as well as the parts that create memory. As the blood becomes more and more saturated with alcohol, females will begin to black out, and then males. Blackouts start at blood alcohol levels of around 0.15. During blackout, or drug-induced brain dysfunction, as it's called medically, the hippocampus stops writing memories. Basically, our 20 to 30 seconds of short-term memory gets full and it resets, and that's all we got. You didn't forget. You weren't even recording, dude! You could ask a blackout drunk person about a story from their childhood, but ask them what happened a few minutes ago? They'd have no idea. A blacked out person is akin to being a walking, talking, unconscious person. Sometimes blackouts let fragments of memories through, but they aren't with all the senses, thoughts, and experiences, and instead, they're just little bits. When we ask our friends, what happened last night, we are extremely vulnerable to suggestion. Those memories were never actually written down, but since the brain is a glutton for context, you will create memories from the stories your friends are telling. It might seem like a lot of people have blackout nights, but really only 40% of college students have ever blacked out. If you do experience them, you're more likely to fall back into them if you drink heavily on a daily basis. Research from the 1940s did find that alcoholism and blackouts were correlated, but since then, we've known that there's no causation. Newer research says some people are more susceptible based on body and brain chemistry, weight, sex, and so on. Anyone can have a blackout if they drink too much, but if they happen too often, it can really mess up your brain chemistry and potentially cause long-term damage, not to mention, you know, bad decision making. So if you want to avoid blackouts, don't drink so fast. Your body can metabolize one drink an hour, and so, you know, go get your buzz on, but don't get crazy. Celebrate St. Patrick's Day responsibly, everybody. Sláinte. What are you doing for the largest Irish-American holiday? Meeting up with other DNews fans to talk science at the pub? Tell us about it below and subscribe. Hey, maybe you're drunk already. If so, why not click that little like button? You like this, right?